Yeah. Kickerverse Music Group. Precise Politics. J Love. Star Saxon, what up? DubCNN.com.
Ain't none of y'all better.
What y'all
know about
putting my work on the block?
Ain't none of y'all better.
None of y'all better.
Let you know it's all real.
Is it real?
None of y'all better.
Yeah, let's get it poppin'. The number one podcast for anything that's rockin'. Microphone masters, daddy, your only option. Sports talk, politics, the new joints droppin'. J-Love and Star Saxon choppin' it up. Kick a verse, collab, precise politics. I stay in the lab, a similar to flex, droppin' the bomb. Write that murder for the dub, CNN.com. I'm the wisdom that'll help your man spot the undercovers. The block that supplies and feeds you and your brothers. The hunger that'll take your hustle to another level. The courage under fire while you letting off the metal. The shine in your bezel when you recognize your worth. The instinct to pop off first. I'm the truth in your lies. The feeling that you other podcasts despise. After you analyze and start to realize,
ain't none of y'all better.
What y'all know about
putting my work on the block?
Ain't none of y'all better.
Let you know it's all real.
Is it real?
Yes.
Ain't none of y'all better.
What do I know? What do I know? What do I know? Yeah. Check it out, yo, yo. Here we go, yo, you know the scenario. Fresh and stereo, 24-7, never weary though. I got fuel to burn to keep the haters away. I'm a gnarly ripper, as the skaters say. Nose grind the stage, my live show is sharp. These puppets getting strings pulled, who playing the harp? Go do your thing, young man, I be standing with the wise. Are you making waves? I be here when you capsize. On a solid foundation, we will never collapse. Learn the rap elements and the periodic at that. So my chemistry super steady, my mic game stay ready. What you know about the mic, Aaron? Eddie. Project glow to my soul, so I got the good life. It's just not me and the music, also got a good wife. That wasn't just for the scheme, we really the dream team. If you need a flicker of light, let me be the sunbeam. But what do I know? What do I know? What do I know? But what I do know is I don't do it for dough. I don't do it for show. Your boy is just born to flow. What do I know? What do I know? But what I do know is I don't do it for dough. I don't do it for show. Your boy was just born to flow. I'm cool as the breeze. I'm Drew in the pocket. Oh snap, I got the power. I'm one with the socket. It's electric. No shuffle. Gotta keep focus. I'm Dr. Strange. No time for your hocus pocus. I'm beyond the norm. I'm above the average. I'm a beast on the mic. Some might say I'm a savage. With the dash of fun, so I'm the total package. If you got some beef, well, dude, bring a side of cabbage. Trying to save your life like I care for your health. I'm off the radar, then I kill your little career. In a stealth, say no to the limelight, rather chill with a low life. I'm winning this race, I'm carefree with no strife. One time for your mind, boy, I'm in my zone. MJ with the glove, better leave me alone. I'm off the wall and I'm bad. Moonwalk through the air, me and ATM, we the most dangerous pair. But what do I know? What do I know? What do I know? But what I do know is I don't do it for dough, I don't do it for show. Your boy was just born to flow. What do I know? What do I know? But what I do know is I don't do it for dough. I don't do it for show. Your boy is just born to flow. Flow.
Like that, you know? Been in this rap game for like the past 4 bullets now, you know? Doing big, yeah, yeah. I done peeped a lot of cats come through. Courageous cats, stray cats. Top cats with top hats, you know what I'm saying? But it all boiled down to this. We talking lyrics, rhymes, line for line. Numero uno, who the best? I don't know. Check it. Flame on, I rain fire when Johnny Storm. I'm shocking like live wire, you have been warned. I prolong this next chamber to make it strong and prove all them doubters wrong. Killing them softly with this song adding on. Let them toes get their tag on. Dead men run no marathon. On my ship, shooting that gift, knowing he snitched on the telethon. Running his lips, sinking the ship. Get back what his mother gave him. Mother made him, and now she can't even save him. Johnny blaze him, send him to his final resting. Back to the essence, faces of death, the final lesson. Torture, 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 motherfucking torture.
Y'all niggas know. Who got John Blaze shit? Sucking my dick to get famous. So I switch Blaze to dangerous. Welcome to my torture chambers where John Doe's remain nameless. Hear me? I know it's Def Jam, but think clearly. I made it possible for y'all cats to come near me. Keep your enemies close and your heat closer. I slam just like my coach, I'm on all theories. Dead dad, straight off the meat rack with this one. You get burned playing with Nick's son. Hot biscuit. Stand back, don't make me spit one and paint pictures on the walls of your mental. With hot lead from out these pencils. Iron lungs since I was young and not knowing where the next meal was coming from. Been troublesome to all those posing a threat. If I go, everybody gotta go next. Y'all niggas know the code of the street soldier. I'm watching time and time watching me colder. Grim Reaper breathing death on my shoulder. Waiting for the day to take me over. Take me over. Torture. 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 Motherfucking torture. Y'all niggas know that you can never touch my flow. Go ahead and hate me. Still trying to fuck my whole Johnny come latelys. Got me in a whirl of shit and now I'm pissed. Mama said there'd be days like this. Tis the season for ducks and my pen's bleeding. Leaving kids barely breathing for sneak thieving. Famished from lack of eating and lack of teaching. Banished from rhyming reason for high treason. Can it be that the kid with the knot knees got G to make a grown man cop plea? For this track I got a love bug like Starsky. Blow back until I drop the cow part. Three. Ain't no stopping when you start me, John Jay. Pulling your card, mayday, mayday. Niggas owe their life to God and now it's payday. Take it how you wanna take it. Fully clothed or butt naked. I learned the hard way, ain't nothing sacred. In this world, time to face it. Johnny basic, instinct, I'm sure to make it. While love is faking, fuck the spotlight. G.O.D. already got light. Say what you like, just spell my name right. No doubt, just one good round to
ready. Kill begins with a baseball bat slap, you burn a brain.
Saxon here. As we record this, this is the week of Halloween, and as we record this, Star Saxon, I don't think he's as nervous now as he was probably about 10 minutes ago, but his Steelers are playing the Dolphins, and we have a great for you. I got my dude, his name is Penny the Great, going to be have a conversation with him. He's here out of the Phoenix metropolitan area, so where I live, so I was happy to be able to link up with him. But Sax, man, you got it. I know we're gonna talk about some horror stories and horror films. Now, this would be your version of the football horror story if you lose to the Dolphins, man.
We ain't losing. We ain't losing. Fuck that.
Oh, man. So let's get right into it, man. You brought up a great topic, and it was appropriate for this time of year, and you wanted to mention. So I'll let you pose it, because I wrote down some of my thoughts, but you had a thought for a great topic, man.
All right, so listeners out there, it's Halloween week. We got the werewolves out. We got the vampires. We got the witch's brew. And we got Transylvania in effect with the pumpkins. So I was speaking to my boy Jay, I was thinking, like, we always talking all this rap shit. But you know what? Maybe we just need to lay that rap shit down for a little bit this week and focus our attention on the thing that makes everybody go bump in the night, which is basically horror and fright. So Jay, let me pose you this question.
Yeah.
We done seen a lot of horror movies over the past couple of decades.
Yes.
But if I had to ask you, to make your top five, can you please give me your top five horror movies? And then after that, I want you to give me your top five horror movie killers.
Okay. Now, see, I'm gonna have to take it a little bit. I'm gonna zoom out because when I was writing my list in terms of so the killers, that's gonna be interesting. I might have to brainstorm this kind of do this freeform thinking, brainstorming out loud. But one of the things that I took, for various reasons, because we know that when we're 6, 7, 8, 9 years old, you have these movies that for some reason they just stick with you over time, right? For various reasons. So there were a few that stuck with me, and I ended up reading the first one. I ended up reading this book, a couple decades later. But the movie The Shining, based off of the book by Stephen King. So that's a great movie. Red Rum. That's an excellent. It's a great movie. Jack Nicholson.
That's really coming at your pod.
Yeah, that's coming in, man. I'm telling you, Shining. Yes, that's going to come in at my five.
So then they made a sequel, right? You know they made a sequel.
They did?
I mean, that shit come out in 2 weeks, homie. Stay woke.
Man, I did not know this, so I guess I do have to stay woke.
Darn, you and McGregor, man. I think it's called something like Dr. Sleep, something like that.
Really?
Okay. Yeah, the little kid. It's about the little kid. He's just older.
Interesting. Okay, I like that. So all right, let's
Shining
see.
Number five.
Yes. So Shining number five. Then I'm gonna go with number four. Saw. I thought Saw was dope. I remember seeing that in the theaters. I thought Saw was dope, especially the twist at the end. For those of you that haven't seen it, I thought Saw was really dope. So Saw.
Okay.
Number three. And you know, you and I, when we were in high school, this movie was out. Candyman.
Yeah.
Nobody wanted to go. You would always taunt your friends and say, well, just go say Candyman five times in the mirror then if you ain't scared. Man, I ain't scared, man. I ain't scared, but I ain't gonna do it. So that's my number three. So, yeah, 5, 4, 3. So then number two, I'm gonna go with this movie. You may have not heard it. This is one of those that just stuck with me from my childhood, from very young age. It's called Phantasm.
Oh shit! Come on, man. The Mortician with the Sphere.
Yeah, man. And then plus the dude that cut his finger off and he bled and he had yellow blood. Yeah.
Hey, yeah, that's classic.
Yeah, and it's one of those as you got older and you started looking at it and saying, I don't know, dog. But at that point in time, yeah, Phantasm. Especially with some of those scenes where he was walking real, where the tall man was walking kind of slow and just the cinematic, the cinematography that went on with that. And then, of course, the one that had, I remember.
It's number one, Jay. Don't blow it.
Number one, sitting in church where they would always talk about this movie, The Exorcist.
Okay.
So that's what I got. So what you got, man? And then I'll give you my villains.
All right. I have to admit, I had a pivot here because Exorcist was on my top five. But listeners, I won't waste your time with duplicates. We carry on. Number five. I got to go with my man, Michael Myers, Halloween Part 1.
Gotcha.
If for no other reason than Donald Pleasance hyping up this psychotic little boy who could take bullets. Yo, he was just like, I looked at this little boy's face, just staring at the wall for 17 years, giving him psychiatric treatment, and then it just dawned on me. I kept staring through this kid and realized there was nothing there. I might have to say that I have gone in a couple of classrooms with some kids to teach my lessons and felt that thought a couple of times. All right. It's fucked up, but it's true, though. Number four, Jason.
Yes.
Friday the 13th, Part 3. Because Part 3 was when Jason finally started putting in work, when he finally brought out the hockey mask, because he wore the bag over his head in Part 2. And his mama was doing the killing in Part 1. So I got to go Jason, Friday the 13th, Part 3, as my number 4. My number 3. Nightmare on Elm Street Part 1. That movie fucked me up, dude. When Johnny Depp got sucked into the waterbed, my interest in procuring a waterbed during my teen years ended immediately.